All right, we will go ahead and get started. Welcome to InfoFree.com's educational webinar. Thank you for joining us. My name is Allie, and I will be going over how to utilize InfoFree.com's email feature through our Contact Manager, or CRM 101. This feature will help you reach out to your prospects and customers to help you create more touch points with them. But first, to give you a little background, InfoFree.com is based out of Omaha, Nebraska, the data capital of the world. We are one of three top data providers in the US, which means we compile the data ourselves, so you're getting the newest, freshest data available. Now I will go over to InfoFree.com's homepage. When you sign in, this is what you will see. And we have the three distinct columns: find new prospects, two, qualify your prospects, and three, convert your prospects. In the first column, you can use these database options to search target businesses with email addresses. There's a couple business options here. And if you're looking only for records with email addresses, you would need to run a search using the businesses with email or executive email database. And if you don't know how to run a business search, I would point you to the other webinars that we've made, one which covers importing leads into the CRM from the business profile or business searches. In my case, I've already run a search for businesses with emails and imported these into my CRM. And from here, we'll jump straight into the CRM. And if you can either click here, view, or my prospects or customers. And it'll bring a new window with our CRM. And on the main dashboard, you can see the email option at the top right of the screen. So if we click here, this brings us to the email features tab. And basically what we're going to be doing is following these three steps, so you can follow along with me as I go. And below, you can also see a few tips and best practices when it comes to sending out your emails to your prospects. To start off, we will go to the email settings tab. That's found up here. And here you can put in your user information for your email address. So that's going to be your name, the email address, the password to that email address, and then your SMTP server and port information. Now, if you are wondering where to find that information, we have links here for Gmail, Outlook, Yahoo, Hotmail, AOL, for the different email providers. If you need help setting these options, feel free to give our customer service team a call and they'd be glad to help you out. And when you have these settings entered, and I've entered mine here, you have a save, so you'll click save. And then you can test the account setting. Now, if it works, this is the message that you're supposed to get. And if you get any other message, just read along with what it says. Sometimes there's a validation email sent to your email address, so you might need to check that to accept that. Otherwise, if you click OK, and like I said, if you need help setting these up, you can always call customer service, and I will give you the number in the chat when we get done. And then now, what you can do, next we'll go ahead and we'll look at the email templates. I was just checking out Dale. Dale, if you go ahead and the SMTP info didn't work and you looked at these links, I would go ahead and give the customer service line a call. It's 877-448-0101. I posted it there for you. All right, so to go forward, here we can go ahead and click Create Email Template. And what we can do here is we can edit our template. We have a drag and drop option that has pre-populated recipient first last name, as well as your personal email address. Just so what I can show you here, if you grab this, my email is going to be my email. And you can throw these in here, and it'll bring up your email address. And then if you want, what happens is when you send out these emails, these will pre-populate with recipient's first name here. You can also throw in the last name if you'd like to there. Totally up to you how you want to create these. And then to save, you'll save it. And then to test, this test actually sends an email to the email address you've linked in the email settings earlier. And here you can check to see how it looks. And let me pull one over for you that I had earlier. This is going to be what the tester looks like. So the recipient's first name, Allie, and then it'll bring in the recipient's first and last name, depending on how you put it, and the links will be clickable. And just, this is, if you like with how this looks, then you're good to go. And then now I'll bring you over to the email templates tab. And here you can see the different templates that you've made. You can edit from here. You'll have a list and then you can bring those up. And that would be like the one that I just showed you for the sample. And let me go back here. Here you can delete, you can see when you created those, you can name those. So I just named that webinar example for this. And now with our template named, we can go back up to prospects. And let me minimize this map here. And in my list, I have some businesses with email. Under this email column, you can see which have email address. Those are going to be the blue envelopes. This one does not. Now, if I go ahead and I click on this envelope, it will automatically pre-populate the to field with the contact's name. And in the template field, you can choose the email template that you'd like to send. And there it also pre-populates the subject and body. And then here we see available email credits for today. You have 250 per day that you can send, and those will be sent one by one. And then when you're ready to go ahead and send, it's just as simple as click and send. And with that, that concludes the CRM email marketing tutorial. It's pretty simple. If you need any help, feel free to give the customer service a call. And now I will open it up for any questions. So Brian, I will go ahead and jump over to the email features here. Here we do have a tip. No, don't spam. Nobody likes spam. Contact your prospect or customer. Let them know that you're following up the conversation or the voicemail with an email. You can verify that email to make sure you have the latest email address. What I would suggest is the Can Spam Act says that you make sure to have an unsubscribe option in your email. And if they do wish to be unsubscribed from your email, just honor that. And so in your template, you can go ahead and put an unsubscribe feature. So just maybe say reply. If you'd like to unsubscribe, reply to this, say unsubscribe me or remove me. So Dale, at the start, how did you get to email? If you'd like to send the emails, you'll go back to prospects. And then you basically click on which contact you'd like to email. And you'll click on these blue envelopes here. And then from there, you can choose your template that we created earlier and then send. All right, and Brian, if you have the Hot Sales Lead app, I would look into that. I don't have my phone by me right now, so I can't check. But I do know the CRM is linked to that Hot Sales Leads app on your mobile device. And Mark, I know you have emails we can get. Is this correct? What are the compliance requirements? So basically, these are not opt-in. These are going to be emails that we have researched, our research team has found. And then it is up to you to get that okay from them. Just contact them and let them know you'll be following up with an email. Dale, when you tested your email, the test account settings, what was the error message? Sometimes Google, I know my Google didn't send me a verification email. It just said it worked right away. Dale, it will depend on which email account you're looking to set up. This is actually Google-based, so it's for me, it's smtp.gmail.com with this port number. And if you looked at these links here, depending on your email provider, check those out, Gmail. Okay, yeah, what you'll do is you'll go ahead and open this up, and it gives you an idea here. So it depends on inbound and outbound mail. So you should, as long as you have your email correct, and your password correct. And Brian, I will look into the templates not being connected to the app. I'll talk to my tech guys to see if that's an option or if maybe there's an error there. And Dale, if neither of those work for you, our customer service can give you a walkthrough of going into your Gmail and Google settings and allow less secure apps to link. I know when I did that, that did work. But it just takes a little bit of digging into the Google settings. And then you should be good to go. But yeah, if you want to call the number, they'd be glad to help you. All right, we'll go ahead and wrap up. Thank you so much for attending. I hope you found this helpful. If you need any more information or you want to walk through a demo of any of these features, feel free to give our customer service line a call. Again, that's 877-448-0101. Or you can visit our website and you can live chat Monday through Friday, 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. Central Time. Thanks, guys. Bye.